In today's video, I'm going to be setting up the Epson XP340 inkjet all-in-one printer. Now, I will be taking you step by step through the setup process. And as with other printers that I set up, I will be doing a full review of this printer as well. So if you haven't already subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe to stay tuned for that full review. The first step after you've got it out of the box is to follow the quick start guide that's provided with the printer to remove all the pieces of packaging tape that are at different points in the printer. So go ahead and do that. And once you're done with this, you can go ahead and plug the printer into a wall outlet. Now pull on the control panel to tilt it to a position that's convenient enough for you to see and use. Now press the green power button on the left so it turns on. When it's powered on for the first time, it asks you to select your language. I'm going to select English and then hit OK. And now it says that it is preparing the printer. And now it wants you to install the cartridges that came with the printer, and I'll show you exactly how to do this. And you don't want to hit the start button just yet. You want to wait till you've installed the cartridges and then hit the start button. And as with most other printers, this printer comes with four different colored cartridges. To start doing this, I'm going to open up this compartment that's right below the scan bed by pushing up on this notch on the side. And once that's open, you'll notice a cartridge tray that is on the right-hand side of this compartment, and that's where we're going to install our cartridges. Once you get each cartridge out of its plastic packaging, you want to shake each cartridge gently, and then remove this piece of yellow tape that's on the side of the cartridge, and then start slotting in each cartridge gently, starting with the black cartridge, and then moving on to yellow, magenta, and then cyan. And when it's all done, you want to make sure that the text is readable and facing you, and that's how you know that the cartridges are properly installed. And now you can close that compartment that we had opened, and then press the start button to begin initializing the cartridges, and let it finish this process. Now this process does take a few minutes, so please be patient with it. And once it's done with that, the printer will display its home screen, and it's time to load some paper. To begin doing this, flip open the lid on the back, then pull up the paper tray and tilt it into position, and then slide out the tray extender, then slide the gray paper guide outwards so that it can fit letter-sized paper, and then insert a few sheets of paper and make sure it is aligned with the guide. And then on screen, you'll see a message that asks you to confirm the kind of paper you've loaded. In my case, it's just plain paper, so I'm going to click OK to confirm this. And once this is done, you should see the home screen appear. Now, one last thing we're going to have to do before we start setting it up on a computer is to connect it to a Wi-Fi network, especially since I plan to use this as a wireless printer, and I'm sure most people are going to use this as a wireless printer. So in order to do that, I'm going to go into the Wi-Fi settings and then click on Wi-Fi Setup Wizard, and then let it search for the Wi-Fi networks that are available. Once it's found the list of available networks, select your network and then hit OK. And now enter your wireless password. You can toggle between uppercase, lowercase, and numbers and symbols using the home key, and then use the up and down arrows to toggle to the exact letter or number you need. Hit OK when you're done and let the printer connect to the wireless network. Once that's done, the rest of the setup can be done on a PC or Mac. I'm going to show you how to set it up on a PC, but the setup on a Mac is identical. Once you're on your PC or Mac, open up a web browser and type in epson.com/support. Hit enter and wait for that page to load up. And then scroll down and then type in XP340 and then select the XP340 from the drop-down menu and wait for the page to load up. Then scroll down and click on the download button next to the drivers and utilities combo package installer and wait for that to download. And once that's done downloading, double click to open up the program and run it. Then click OK on the next window that opens up, and then wait for it to start extracting the files. And now a new window opens up that asks you to accept the terms and conditions. I'm going to click accept. And now it wants to know what software you'd like to install. I recommend installing everything except the Epson user guide link and the research participation software. Epson's just trying to sneak this stuff in there, and I don't recommend installing it. And then click install. And then it lets you know that it's downloading the software, and it shows you a progress bar on the bottom. And then it continues to install the software, and this could take a few minutes. And now it wants to start setting up the printer. I'm going to click next. And now it wants to know how I'd like to connect to my printer. In my case, I'm going to select wireless connection, which is what most people are going to select, and then click next. And now it's asking if the printer is already on the wireless network or needs to be set up. Now, it doesn't have the ability to automatically connect to the wireless network from the software like some HP printers do. You have to connect it to the wireless network from your control panel on the printer itself, like we did earlier. And since we did that earlier, we're going to say that the printer is already on our network and then click next. And then it begins the network setup, as you can see here, and this could take a few minutes. At this point, the setup is complete and it allows you to print a test page. I highly recommend printing that test page just to make sure everything's working correctly. And after the test page prints out, it asks you whether you'd like to set up any cloud printing services which allow you to print from anywhere to this printer. Now that's up to you if you'd like to do this. I'm not going to do this in this case. I'm just going to uncheck it and click next. And I'm going to say yes on the next window that opens up. And now it says the setup is complete. You should be at this point able to print from this PC or any mobile device on your network. However, if you need to print to it using a Mac, you'll have to do a similar setup on the Mac. It's almost identical. And that's it. Your printer is now set up and ready to print. And as I said earlier, I will be doing a full review of this printer. So stay tuned for that if you haven't already subscribed. Please subscribe to stay tuned for that full review. I'll also leave a link to this printer and cartridges for the printer right below this video if you'd like to buy one. Hope this video has been useful. If it has, please give us a big thumbs up. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.